Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
Typically, any B school student would say this, who had passed out in the last few years, would say this. They would have all heard of this word called VUCA: volatility, uncertainty, complexity, ambiguity, right? So they would have all heard about VUCA, and it would have been just another word in the literature. They would have definitely learned a little bit about it, but this is the first time that this generation is actually seeing what it means to be living in a VUCA world.
At a time when higher education is slowly going back to where we left it when the pandemic started, the new batch of MBA students are also undergoing the new model of education. To talk more about the future of MBA education and whether an MBA is the need of the hour, we have a special guest with us today. I welcome Dean of Academics of TAPI Management Institute, Manipal, Professor Vaishnathan Iyer. Professor Iyer is a professor in the area of finance and accounting and has taught at various business schools and held administrative positions for the last two decades. Welcome, Professor Iyer, to this conversation, and thank you for taking time out for us.
Thank you.
To begin with, what is your opinion of the current education scenario? How do you see the education system changing in the near future?
Current scenario is such that both business education as well as the schools, both have been impacted, and you will see it playing out both in the immediate short run as well as in the medium run. Okay. So if I have to say quickly about the schools per se, the ones which are at the top or reasonably doing well, they have invested in the technology over a period of time and were able to quickly jump, right, and switch to online mode of education, bring in a lot of technological changes. The people and processes were geared quickly. So that sort of helped the schools to adapt to this new reality. Whereas the ones which did not, obviously had a very, very difficult time in continuing their education as well as recruiting new students. Typically, any B-school student would say this, who had passed out in the last few years, would say this. They would have all heard of this word called VUCA: volatility, uncertainty, complexity, ambiguity, right? So they would have all heard about VUCA, and it would have been just another word in the literature. They would have definitely learned a little bit about it, but this is the first time that this generation is actually seeing what it means to be living in a VUCA world. This crisis has, shown its might on everyone, whether you are a company, formal sector, informal sector, service sector, business schools, right, consultants, everybody has been affected. So therefore, this has been, in one sense, as an educationist, I would say, this has been a great time for all of us to reflect on what is happening, learn from the environment, adapt our education.
From your response, what I got was you are a believer of necessity is the mother of invention. And I'm sure you have implied that to your B school also, and the kind of academic structure that you have woven around that. So I'm curious to know a little bit more about, you know, how TAPMI is dealing with this particular pandemic and the aftermath of it.
There is a saying, fortune favors the brave, or there is a modified version of that, fortune favors the prepared ones, right? So to some extent, I would say we were fortunate. This entire crisis, we started seeing the impact of it in March. So by then, we had finished our most of the rounds of admissions. And by then, by mid-March, we had also completed the second year's coursework was over. First year's coursework were almost in the last week. I mean, last two, three sessions were pending. So to that extent, we were really fortunate. So we could immediately send the students back home. Fortunately, we had initiated this smart classroom projects a while ago. I'm saying we were just lucky, right? So we had already, for executive education, I mean, the idea was something else, but we got the benefit of it in a very different way. We never anticipated this. So we had already prepared some of our classrooms for executive education, and some were already in the pipeline, right? So we could, over those 2 months, we could quickly prepare a lot of our classrooms, equip it for conducting sessions.
Historically, we have seen that whenever there is a crisis, people always go towards education. What do you think is this connection, and why do you think that happens, and do you think that is a good practice that people do?
Yes, people use this as an opportunity to upskill themselves, right? So many of them who run a risk of being laid off would want to use this opportunity to upskill themselves. Many of them who are rank freshers and who did not have great undergrad education. See, so again, there is a huge heterogeneity in the undergrad education in our country, right? Some of them are really brilliant schools and we have bright students coming out of them who are comparable to students coming out of slightly lower rank master's education schools. You know, I mean, that's the heterogeneity in quality. Whereas many other schools in this country and students are not fortunate to have gone through such top-ranked undergrad schools. So those students would really have a difficult time getting jobs, right? So instead of wasting time, it's a good practice to upskill yourself in whatever way you think is best, depending upon what you can do, what is your base level competency. And our country is no exception to that human behavior. It's human behavior at the end of the day, right? So that's the reason why intake goes up. And in the 40 years of our existence, you know, I would say this is the highest intake DAPME has ever seen. 556 students that we have seen intake across all four programs. This is not just PGDM.
Professor Iyer, it's very interesting that, you know, you have personally seen one of these crises unfold. You were doing your PhD at that point in time and you were finishing it off, and then you were also looking at your career ahead. Going back to that time, how would you compare that time with the times that we are in right now?
Between 2006 to 8, I completed my PhD. So 8 is when I had my defense. That was another era. Of course, that was a financial crisis. What we are seeing is something very different, right? But that crisis also brought in a lot of changes in the mindset of people, changes in the way we conducted education, changes in the way students speak. So that crisis actually was more in the sector, I would say. You know, faith in the finance sector took a serious beating, and not just practitioners, even academics took a beating in that period, you know. And one very interesting thing that we saw, not surprising, but interesting, the batch immediately after that, large portion of the students swung to marketing as a specialization, moved out of finance, okay? Mostly because people felt more jobs were in business development and rather than core finance. So those were the immediate shocks then, right? So I would say that was more a sectoral shock. But as I said, these are two very, very different times.
Keeping in mind that the kind of times that we are living in and the kind of times that are coming for us, for the students also who are going to different B schools, what do you think are some of the skills that they definitely need to pick up from here on, and what will make them the better managers or future leaders of tomorrow?
Communication is the most important thing. And in these times of distributed work environment, communicating, managing projects in such a way that the task is distributed and you are able to aggregate it, right? So that's most invaluable skill, at least in the near future. In terms of expectations, attitudinal change has to come.
The bigger question, I think, for a lot of these aspirants who want to, you know, get into this space and get into these schools to do their MBA is whether it is the right time to do an MBA or not. They're always in this to mind whether to do this MBA or go for, you know, a job experience, keeping in mind also that maybe the job market is not as strong as it was earlier and whether they would get a job at this point in time. So what's your opinion on that?
First thing, if you are a rank fresher and you don't come from those premier undergrad schools, not great undergrad education, definitely the only thing that you should do is upskill yourself. Now to the ones who are, let me pick the category of people who have worked for 2 years. By the time you complete your education, in over the next 2 years, you would see a huge pickup of demand in the economy, and there will be a booming of the overall economy, right? We are going to see really good times. So in that sense, if you equip yourself. So you have the advantage of that sweet spot of, you know, between 1.5 to 2.5 years of work ex. That's a sweet spot. If you are in that spot, this is the best time to get into management education. Prepare yourself, leverage on your background, do a fantastic internship and do good projects. And when the market is ready, you would also be ready for a perfect takeoff. People beyond that sweet spot, let's say beyond 4 years of work ex, I would say do not get out of job at this point in time.
On this note, I would like to know a little bit about the kind of plus point or the USP that students can get if they enroll themselves to your institute at TAPME, which we all know has been operational for decades now.
That we are one of those very few schools in our country who, you know, which puts very huge emphasis on research. And that helps us in a big way. Research both, research both in terms of what is happening at a slightly higher level of how the business is going, and research also in terms of what is happening at a grassroots level. We also work very hard at case level, that is developing new cases, understanding how companies operate. So that's another knowledge that we get at grassroots level, which we transmit to our students, right? Both in terms of business cases, both in terms of sustainability and social projects and social internship kind of cases. So therefore, at both levels, you would find that TAPME is really firing on all cylinders to take that learning to the students. At a higher level, at the evolution of knowledge itself, at course level in terms of introducing courses jointly with practitioners, and also giving you hands-on experience of live projects and cases, both with companies and in the social space. So we provide our students exposure at all these three levels.
Any final advice or parting message to all the aspirants who are, you know, still in double minds whether to do an MBA?
Think very carefully. From what school are you pursuing your education? Number one. So if you're a fresher, you have to. And I would say you shouldn't even wait till the next June, July. You should use the time wisely. You should use this time. Even if you are in the final years of undergrad or if your undergrad education is over, use this time wisely to pick up small courses from online education sources, right? Learn. It is that hunger for knowledge and wanting to know. That's from the online space. Second, read papers daily, right? Understand nature around us is the best teacher. Look at what is happening to businesses around us. Most important, reflect for yourself. Remember, it is your life. It is not my life. It is not somebody else's life. It is not even your parents' life. It is your life and your career. Start taking responsibility by thinking carefully for yourself. You will start understanding and finding answers.
Thank you very much, Professor Iyer, for this conversation.